Aloha mai kākou. I'm Vicky Hope Takamine, the Executive Director of Pa'i Foundation and your co-MC for tonight's show.
Aloha, I'm Robert Muluvehi Casimero, and I am a co-host for tonight.
Aloha, I'm Michael Pili Pang, I'm the other co-host for this evening.
Welcome to tonight's show. We're so happy that you're all here. I hope you have your poo-poo, okay?
Yep.
And your mea inu, your favorite mea inu, whatever that might be, okay? Mm-hmm. So
juice.
A little sparkly juice.
Mm-hmm. There you
cheering.
Go. Cheering.
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 I have tea.
Tea. Cheers.
Cheering to you, brother.
Ta-da. We're supposed to be social distance, okay?
This is social distance for me.
In the boxes.
A shared box.
Right. Tonight, Pa'i presents the 2020 MAMo Wearable Art Show. A showcase of Hawaiian art, culture, fashion, and design from the last 14 years of MAMo Wearable Art Shows.
From Kona, Hawaii, one of our favorite designers, Nita Pilago, Wahine To'a.
My art and designs are from my family. All of us draw the art and then we print it on fabric. Of course, our inspiration comes from our beautiful Hawaiian islands and all of the aspects of it, the wind, the rain, the flowers, and the aina. The MAMo show has elevated my purpose, I would say, in the fashion industry. I didn't know anything about, you know, walking the stage or, you know, having the models and everything, makeup, fashion. Vicky taught me how to do it, and not only her team, they just came and embraced me and embraced all of our designers, actually, just to make us feel that, you know, we are part of this big renaissance, a fashion renaissance in Hawaii. Vicky took us to heights where I never dreamed of, you know, big time fashion shows at Hawaii Theater and the Hilton, so it has really put me on the map as a fashion designer, and I'm really appreciative and grateful. We use the hula halau models, the dancers, and all of the girls is all willing and able, and just regular everyday people, all shapes and sizes. And I was so honored and blessed to have them wear my clothes on stage, and more so blessed when they're dancing on stage with my clothing. I wanted to empower women, and women from any size, any race, any age. And because I just wanted everyone to look good and feel good. And when they wear my pieces, they can feel the positive energy that we put into it. I got a lot of feedback from women. When they get a compliment, they said, wow, somebody complimented me. And when you get a compliment, you know, it just elevates your happiness and how you feel about yourself. And that's what I want, really simple. And my clothing is for every day. I just designed my styles for everyday wear and everyday living. So that is what MAMo is, wearable art. And we all have our own different styles and genres. And when you put it all together, it's so beautiful on stage, so grateful.
Kona, look at what I'm wearing. I'm wearing Anita. I'm wearing a Wahine Toa. I should have been on that ramp. I tell you.
You know, it's hard because you have so many things to do in the MAMo show. You're everywhere.
I'm everywhere. Okay, but thank you so much.
We love you.
We love you.
We just love you.
Thank you, Anita.
Love you, Tia. Are we going backstage?
Oh,
is it
that
time?
Would be a good thing. I forgot all about it because I'm so happy it's not me. He always looks, Keone Nunes, I'm sorry, he looks at us, he looks at me like I'm pork chops. And he can't wait to put one stamp on top of me. So,
are we able to go back or am I jumping the gun? Aloha, Keone.
Aloha.
Pehea oko.
Oh, Maika iho iwao. You know, I'm good. I don't feel nothing. I'm good. I'm great.
You're doing well. So I had a question I thought you might ask because we talked about that in the very beginning, and I always say kakao and we say tattoo, but you shared a term, uhi. Can you explain to us the difference between those terminology?
Yeah. Kakao is actually the verb. That's what you're doing. What remains is the uhi. And the uhi is what we would look at now and term tattoo, yeah? There's always been several really huge misconceptions about traditional tattoos, one of which is that it's really slow, and this is way faster than a machine for the amount of work that I'm doing. And that it's really, really painful. There are certain spots that are painful, I'm not gonna lie. But for the most part, I would never get a machine tattoo because it hurts too much. This doesn't hurt as much as a machine tattoo. So, you know, we have to decolonize our thoughts as to what is Hawaiian. This is Hawaiian. This is who we are.
There's a light at the end of the tunnel, Kaloku. Auntie Vicky loves you.
Uncle Robert loves you too. Thank you so much.
Mahalo. Wow. Okay. Kaloku o kamaile o kamehameha. It's my kai. Such a good boy. He really is a good boy.
Well, Keone Nunes, wow. You know, he scares me. He looks at me and I feel like a piece of pork chop. Like he wants to get in there and put some kind of design on me. Like how he did on Kaloku. And I tell you, that was painful.
My poor nephew. I know, Kaloku. I was like, oh my God. I mean, that was so interesting to be present when I asked Keone to do this and do it live backstage. I really wasn't prepared for that. So, coming up, Marcus Hanalei Marzan.
For this particular collection, I really wanted to include natural materials in every way I could. So I used organic, you know, natural fibers, cotton, silks. I use cordage made from coconut fiber, sennet cord, tea leaves, dried tea leaves, all of these different natural materials to really bring together these different elements. You know, the idea of bringing together the akua and aumakua through different materials is something that I also like to kind of play with, you know, with the la'i, you know, the idea of healing and medicinal qualities, the idea of cordage being something for everyday use, for canoes, for housing, lashing, connecting to kuku. So balancing these different energies in the collection is something I really liked playing with to really create a full context and not just a single piece that stands alone on, but really a world that is created. I've been very fortunate to have models that have stuck with me from the very beginning, and I use them year after year, and I'm really close to them. So I really cherish the connection that I already have with my models, and that is really the connection that I use to create the works that I do. it is not just, again, for me, it's not just a piece of art, but it really is an extension of my relationship with my models and the friendship that I have with them and how I'm able to bring the best out of them through the work that I do. I don't consider myself a fashion designer. A lot of people call me a fashion designer because I create clothes that are, or collections that are worn on the body. But I do think of myself as an artist, a contemporary visual artist. And my art is just so happens to be worn on the body. The wearable works that I create really do only come to life on a person. And oftentimes, the creations that I've made over the years for MAMo are specific to the models. And the energy and mana that they bring to activating my work is really the full culmination of my work. To see it on a mannequin is one thing, but to see it on a living person and seeing it moving, seeing it bring the haka, you know, the person, into another level of consciousness, seeing them have pride moving, seeing them have confidence wearing the works, seeing them look at the world in a different way through my while wearing my work is really the joy that I have in making the works that I do.
That's awesome. My cat, mahalo.
He's always fabulous. Look at the way he uses the designs, the pe'ahi, the ali'i, you know, symbolism. Always great.
He never disappoints. Never. Always good stuff.
Always fabulous.
Yay, Marcus.
Yeah, it's not just the pe'ahi, but it's also printed on the fabric, so, and all using all natural materials.
Yep.
Really creative. So, my kai mahalo, and very innovative.
Keiki who are nurtured become tomorrow's leaders.
It's my kuleana to make my voice heard.
I honor the ho'oilina of my kupuna.
I have the power to uplift my lahui and inspire the world.
We believe in the ability of every child. When more opio are empowered to lead, the lahui thrives.
Aloha, welcome to Olaka'i Lua Art Space Labs, an affordable housing project for artists. This will be the new home for the Pa'i Arts and Culture Center, where you will enjoy Native Hawaiian art, music, hula, and storytelling. Please come and visit us, the Pa'i Arts Gallery, our dance studio. We welcome everyone to our new center. Please visit us at www.pa'ifoundation.org. Aloha.
The Culture and Arts Relief and Recovery Funds are coming soon. We set aside $10 million tailored just for our community.
Go to oneoahu.org.
Go to oneoahu.org.
If you are a cultural practitioner, a kumu hula, a halau hula, an entertainer, or fit into any one of the other categories of being an arts and cultural practitioner, this program is for you.
Go to oneoahu.org to apply.
Apply now.
Apply now.
Pa'i is pleased to partner with the National Endowment for the Arts,
Artworks, the State Foundation of Culture and Arts, Hawaii Tourism, and donors like you
to present a series of events, concerts, and workshops featuring Native Hawaiian artists and cultural practitioners.
You can find more information on our events and programs at www.pa'ifoundation.org.
Our next designer is Kavika Lum Nelmida. Beautiful, beautiful crafts.
think for me, it's a sense of accomplishment when I finish a piece and to see the excitement and gratitude on someone's face, as well as knowing that this is a mark in history for that person or that group. I mean, these pieces really were made to last for a really long time. It's kind of like leaving your mark on the world in a small way. When I was invited to participate in the MAMo Wearable Art Show in 2017, the inspiration I had for this particular fashion show was taken from dresses that I've seen worn by the ali'i at a palace ball. So creating these dresses for the wahine and for the kane, the jackets, they were made to be for a ball or a gala event. In my research of Hawaiian featherwork, feathers were a very spiritual part of that connection to our ancestors on the spiritual plane. Ahu worn by ali'i were mainly covering spiritual entry points on your body or your kino, whether it was on the back or the top of the head. It gives you a connection. Manu and birds can reach every plane, physical plane, which was very important for us as Hawaiians to differentiate the different planes, whether it's in the kai or on the aina, in the nahele, and the different levels of the lani. So manu give us that connection where they bridge every aspect of our physical realm. I do think being a hulu practitioner, you definitely need a grounding and a basis for a lot of hard work. It's very time consuming, and it does take a lot of focus. But I would like to see everyone at least try to make one, just to see if you like it. Maybe you can be the next hulu practitioner.
That Kavika,
I want
so
one of those dresses.
I know.
You think I could wear one of those? I want to go to the ball. You think if we had Iolani Palace was at the ball, I could wear that? Oh, and then which one of you is going to wear the malo?
Well, you know, I'll be in Japan. We'll just leave it. Vicky, how can you ask that question? I'm kind of like verklempt right now. But they were.
Awesome.
I tell you, that Kavika, he's talented, yeah.
He's all beautiful. The use of feathers. Yeah. Fabulous use of feathers. Yeah.
Hulu. My ka'iloa.
And now my neighbor, Manuhe Ali'i Dininlan.
There's really something that's special about us, and we can't be the only ones to like celebrate it and show it off to other people. But it wasn't like we were respected in any way, or I mean, they just thought of me as some cute little Hawaiian girl that wanted to make some Hawaiian clothing, and you know, when you go and get a loan, they're kind of, oh, that's so sweet, you're sewing and doing a cottage industry. And they didn't even think that you could grow a design company based around our culture, what's relevant. I mean, just to them, a Hawaiian print was a hibiscus or, you know, just some corny Hawaiian thing. Just knowing that I could do anything, and then all that secret knowledge I had that I could just do it in the middle of the night at my home while kids were sleeping, it was just it's powerful to know that this is something you can do. When you're a startup, you're always developing and you're thinking of basically just ways how to make money. You're trying to think how you're going to have a successful business to last more than 1 week. You're just trying to make more money than you put into it. For designing for me and creating starts with my heart and what I feel like. For me, the inspiration is always my family. So, you know, that celebration, that joy that we, that when we connect and we love each other, it's all I really want to celebrate, you know? So when I design around those good memories and dreams and wishes that I have, you know, I want to design something for my grandmother and for my mother and then for my kids and for me. And I, you know, that kind of encompasses everything that you want to do with design. But it's based on just creating and having all these things to celebrate. So it kind of is, it's easy to design. It's easy to want to grow because you're looking at all these people that you're responsible to. So when you're responsible to somebody and you're trying to just celebrate all this happiness that we share, it's, you know, you're just trying to translate that from how do I go from this wonderful feeling to something tangible, that this is the outfit that I want to wear to this celebration, or this is the graphics that I want to design to honor our parents or our grandparents or what future dreams I have for the kids. And it's everyday life. So when everybody asks how does your business last so long, it's because every single collection is more like it's a new beginning all the time. So it doesn't feel like we've been in business for so long. It feels like we've been in business for 40 days until the next collection comes out, because every collection is new. So it's like the graphics, the colors, the inspiration, all of that just gets rolled into the next collection, and then we just keep doing it over and over. Once you're creative, I think you kind of, that's just your life. That's your ano, that's your being, you know? You can't change it.
Always my favorite designer, like the clothes I'm wearing, Manuhea Ali'i. You know, Deneen always comes back with something great. You know, she's been there since 1985, designing clothing, and you know, one of the trendsetters now. And the clothes is just out, you know, priceless, beautiful work. Thank
that
you.
That was such a fun set. Did you happy in your seat? You know, I mean, we were like, it's so fun. Her models were so happy and loved it.
Great job, Manuhea Ali'i. Great job.
All of my love I'll give to you. When I come home.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ho'ololi and the Sunny Ching Collection by Paradisus.
We have been a part of MAMo from its earliest years. And they used or modeled the costumes that were designed for an avant-garde show called Iku Kanaka. So being that the costuming was avant-garde, it kind of fit in with what MAMo was trying to achieve. I was really happy to send our dancers and they had a great time. And then a few years later, I'm really not sure if I was asked again or if I said, hey, I want to do this. Do you think I can? But I know I wanted, I did my second MAMo and it was at Hawaii Theater. As far as I know, jewelry was never showcased or focused on in a runway presentation for MAMo. Of course, jewelry and accessories were used, but it was usually used to accent or accessorize the fashion that was being shown. So this was just a little bit different, where it was the jewelry that was the focus. So all of the clothing that the models used were white. We created all of the styles, all of the women's things we had sewn, and some of the men's things, but like the men's jeans or shorts, I actually just bought them from various stores, you know, here in Hawaii. It was kind of funny because it was a jewelry presentation and it was really well received. It was probably the most creative show for me because it combined hula, chanting, live singing. I wrote the music, I wrote the chant. So it was a really, really awesome experience for me, my first runway show. You know, another thought is popped into my head to maybe explore that avenue of actually putting together clothes or designing a line of clothes to put together with the jewelry to showcase that. So I always say MAMo was for me in fashion what Mary Monarch was for our halau in hula. That first participation in MAMo helped me to become known as not only a kumu hula, but to become known as a jewelry designer and a fashion designer.
Yay, Sunny, so talented. All that silver jewelry with all those intricate designs, just beautiful motifs.
You know, it's so interesting too, because people, you know, you think of Sunny, and Sunny's a kumuhula, of course. He does great work, Mary Monarch and stuff like that. And branching out in this new direction is refreshing and inspiring for not so talented people other than hula like me.
Well, it just shows us how talented all us kumuhulas are.
No, there you go. I'll tell you. Dim sum?
Dim sum. I have a cookie.
Okay, all right. Yay, Sunny.
Keiki who are nurtured become tomorrow's leaders.
It's my koleana to make my voice heard.
I honor the ho'oilina of my kupuna.
I have the power to uplift my lahui and inspire the world.
We believe in the ability of every child. When more opio are empowered to lead, the lahui thrives.
Aloha, welcome to Olakailima Art Space Lofts, an affordable housing project for artists. This will be the new home for the Pa'i Arts and Culture Center, where you will enjoy Native Hawaiian art, music, hula, and storytelling. Please come and visit us, the Pa'i Arts Gallery, our dance studio. We welcome everyone to our new center. Please visit us at www.pa'ifoundation.org. Aloha.
The Culture and Arts Relief and Recovery Funds are coming soon. We set aside $10 million tailored just for our community.
Go to oneoahu.org.
Go to oneoahu.org.
If you are a cultural practitioner, a kumu hula, a halau hula, an entertainer, or fit into any one of the other categories of being an arts and cultural practitioner, this program is for you.
Go to oneoahu.org to apply.
Apply now.
Apply now.
E hula kako. Let's hula together. Fiki and Jeff Takamine, Nākumu Hula of Pua Ali'i Ilima, are excited to announce open enrollment for new students from Keiki to Kupuna. You can register for a 12-week introductory class to our Halau Hula, Pua Ali'i Ilima, at www.paifoundation.org. We look forward to meeting you. E komo mai.
Our next designer has her factory right in Kalihi, where I grew up. Ari South.
That first MAMo show was just chicken skin. Everything happened so perfectly. We definitely were running down to the wire backstage, even getting the models dressed in time. Like, I think we were being called and nobody was dressed. So by some miracle, we made it on stage on time. We had a mixture of live music and recorded audio. And we'd never really rehearsed it all together until that night. But when I watched the show backstage, it seemed that everything just aligned. And for me, that was a bold statement from my ancestors and my kupuna saying that they were there. Seeing my show on the MAMo runway was very different from any show that I've done before. Because previously I was focused on doing shows within the fashion industry, which isn't necessarily rooted in culture. It isn't necessarily rooted in, and when we say rooted in culture, that comes along with like spirituality, cultural practice, something much deeper than just clothing. Watching the fashion show for the first time at MAMo, it was surreal. It was bringing together hula sisters to model. It was bringing together musicians, vocalists, and especially having Kamakaiva Oli live was probably the cherry on the pie. Seeing the show come together on that runway was like bringing my life and business, which was very much just fashion and running a business, and the things that I love. To bring those two things together was really important for me because I was trying to for years. And so to finally see it, it was one of many dreams come true. 10 years ago, I competed on season 8 of Project Runway. And I completed as a finalist, so I made it all the way to New York Fashion Week. And that's kind of what catapulted my career. The time between school and Project Runway was a lot of working for smaller companies, dancing and doing costumes, so a lot of exploration. But the show really kind of kicked my butt into like just doing it. It definitely has been a journey of faking it till we make it. It's been a lot of figuring out things on the way, you know. Everything in the fashion business has been kind of elusive, right? And so I think now it's a little bit different. But back then, it was not easy to find out the things we can find out just by social media now, as to like how to do it, how to get started. Coming from a design background, I approached design looking at cut, fit, fabrication first. Print didn't really kind of come into play until right before my show with Pa'i Foundation. At the time, what I was really drawing inspiration from is my idea that ideas come to us from kupuna, from ancestors. I think people like to take claim a lot to having a great idea and having it first, but what I've observed is a lot of things will just circulate, and some might say inspiration, but I actually think that, you know, the same idea in hula where we're used as a vessel, the same idea I apply to anything, whether it be any kind of art, for me it's design. I think that I'm a conduit and a vessel and that's it. You know, I'm just the lucky one that gets chosen to bring these things to life.
Yes, you know, I saw her on Project Runway, and it was so fun when to have her come home and be a part of our MAMo Wearable Art Show. So come to Kapalama Kalihi, go to the factory, give Ari a call. It'll be great to have you wear an Ari sock.
So comfortable too.
And she's a wonderful person.
Yeah.
Yay! From Hilo, Hawaii, Taupori Tangaro.
Whether you're dancing about something 2,000 years ago or something 200 years from now, we're predicting through hula, it doesn't matter, it's still hula. And so the cord work is very similar to that because the pico, our belly button, is an important reality in this world of hula. It's the ieve that connects us to all of our ancestors. And hula is that ieve in a dance form. I work with cord work that's informed by kokopu'upu, traditional netting with specific kind of knotting techniques. And I create wearables based on one artifact at the Bishop Museum, where there is a ki'i very similar to this one here in a corded pa'u. I just needed one artifact and it opened up the world. I use cord and the regalia in ritual to get people to see what it means to have 4,094 ancestors, 400 years of ancestors creating you. Over the years, I've pulled miles and miles of cord, you know, and it's about, and it's unlike other cord work in that it's only one cord, which is a strong kind of imprint and a reminder that, you know, we descend from a very, very long line of people. And when we stand up and we speak and we're in leadership, especially cultural leadership, all those people stand up with us too. And this nodding has become a great metaphor to bring that reality forward into this time. Anytime there was imbalance in his community, he transformed into a cord to lash the balance all over again. So we're using the tradition, we're evolving tradition, we're using our mythology, our original records of consciousness to create new avenues of seeing ourselves in this world in leadership. And so when we wear the cord, it's an outer expression of what's already in our bodies. I have a loose idea of what I want to produce. You know, I think of silhouettes and nodding, and I try to put them together, but I don't know how much pieces I've created over these years. Not one of them came out as intended. After the first mile of cord, it seems to go in its own direction, and I have to let it go. You know, I live in a world of control. I live in a world of choreography. But when I'm working with cord, I have to allow it to control me. So, you know, the outcomes, it's all their own. There's somebody else behind me at that moment or inside of me, and I just go with it. So it's a great feeling to know that I don't have to be in control all the time.
Have a great big round of applause for Taupori Tangaro from Hilo, Hawaii.
Yay,
that show, I will never forget how fabulous it was on Maui. How fabulous that show was, and how together he was with his people, and it was, you know, so organic in a way. It just kind of like I knew it took a lot of work, But it just happened, and the whole idea of tying knots, and I think it's something that he works together with...
Kelly Rachel and Marcus Marzan, yeah. They all kind of get together, and they're fascinated with rope tying knots. It's a traditional craft and a traditional art on canoes, on va'a, on jewelry, on a lot of things. But
it's just so beautiful the way they've taken it and moved it forward. Mm-hmm. That idea of Niki, you know, to tie forward and to tie back and pull forward and pull back, that's what we do in life. You know, and to see how symmetrical the whole thing is, how beautifully it's done, I'm just amazed. I'm really amazed.
Yeah, yeah, and mahalo to Maui Arts and Culture Center and for Kahulu.
Yes.
Yeah, for providing the venue. It's a wonderful opportunity to involve other artists from other from our neighbor islands too.
Yep. Yeah.
So mai kai loa, mahalo. Leiko Hawaii ka waka au he alo na mauna kui ka hau hea ai a mai ka ai pai halala he au he ave o he ave a he ave o ke lugi a tua mo o poli a hua he a kua nui.
And now, kahula le'a and fabulous designer Kehaulani Nielsen.
Growing up, there wasn't many Native Hawaiian designers. So if someone told me that we'd be where we were at when we were a child, like I would say, gosh, no way. There wasn't enough representation at the time. There wasn't enough people showing us that it's possible. So when you have people telling you that your stuff is good enough, you know, that's empowering. You know, that's like your own cheering team. and I think, you know, like people need that. They need to have a cheer team behind them and encourage them. Kahula Le'a started in 2013, and really it just was a creative outlet for me, and I wanted to make my time productive. So I borrowed my mother-in-law's sewing machine, and I started upcycling my old hula costume, because at the time I was hapai with my daughter Kahula Le'a, and you know, those weren't going to fit anymore. I equate fashion just like hula, you know. I mean, we as hula dancers design our costumes for years. And hula is not just about the motion. It's not just about the music. It's about the way you dress yourself and what is the prints on your clothing as well. So really, fashion is just another avenue to express all of that we learn in hula. It's just incredible, and I think that's what the MAMo Fashion Show has done for so many Native Hawaiian designers, children still watching it today. People, we don't even know that's going to one day be Native Hawaiian designers as well. It showcases people like them that came from backgrounds like them, wearing clothing that they can relate to. I mean, that's empowering for people, you know, like representation, being able to see things that we can relate to, you know, and on beautiful clothing, on beautiful products. Just having this amazing fashion show, like startup brands all over the world, they don't get that. They don't get that. People don't realize how much, not for one, money, but just the teamwork of people that go behind putting such a well thought out and professional show on, how much effort that takes. It just doesn't happen often, you know? And here we are in Hawaii, and we are allowed to, we're new brands, and we get to showcase that to an audience that cares, you know, and loves and is so excited to see it. I mean, that is just, it's such an amazing thing to be a part of.
Wow, that was awesome. Kahula le'a. Kehaolani Nielsen, it was amazing. You know, she first showcased providing accessories for some of the designers, her handbags as accessories. But to move from accessories into a whole line of clothing, amazing.
And then to actually have a shop today at Ala Moana Shopping Center.
Yep.
That's just amazing. Quite a few.
Quite a few of them. And, you know, that gives a credit to this program, MAMo Wearable Art Show and Pa'i Foundation, whose, you know, platform has always been to support the artists.
Yeah. So Pa'i, our mission is to perpetuate Native Hawaiian cultural practices for future generations. And I think one of the things that I like about this is that we provide artists, all artists, visual, fashion, performing artists, a platform to showcase their art. And then hopefully we can give them, you know, like this is a great work sample for future, you know, commissions or work. So mahalo to everybody for taking the leap with us. Yay. Yay, Pa'i.
It's been so interesting to see the work of Keone Nunes. Enjoy.
We want to check in with Keone Nunes. Keone, are you Makaukau? How is Kaloku?
Wapau.
Wapau. All right. So.
Hiki ai ke holovava.
Can you walk?
Hiki no, hiki no.
Are you able to come out?
Hiki no.
Hiki?
Hiki no.
Okay, let's see it.
He is a master artist in what he does.
Yeah,
and
he really
had people from all over the Pacific coming over to get a tattoo. But I'm like Robert, I'm not a piece of pork chop.
No, and you know, the thing about it is he would say to me, I had the dream already, I know what I'm going to do. I was like, in my mind, in the front, I would be like, yes, oh wow, that's so great. Behind me, it's like, run, run, run. But he's terrific, though.
Yeah, what an amazing, amazing artist.
I love this designer from Kohala, how not but to love him. Manaola, Carrington, Baba, Yap.
The quest for knowledge begins with the search to unlock the past. As man connects with nature, his answers are heard on the whispers of the winds.
Manaola, which is actually our brand now, was developed actually from hula. My childhood was very different from the normal childhood, whereas, you know, after school was finished, the work was never finished. So, you know, we were always making costumes and, you know, making kukui nut oil for dyes or dyeing fabric or learning mele or, you know, dancing hula or learning chants or doing research, you know. So those are the kinds of things that invigorated my ability to be creative in a different way.
Who may come a kanipiliako kaniku?
every time I made an outfit or a costume, my hula sisters or my hula brothers that I was dancing with, I would find that all my costumes started disappearing. And then I would go out with them and I'd walk into the bar and then I'd see my hula sister with my top and then she has it, you know, sporting it with jeans. And then, you know, I see all of our show costumes in that space. And, you know, a lot of them were just like, oh yeah, I borrowed this. I was like, okay, you know, you gotta tell me first before you take these pieces outside of the, you know, out of the show. But a lot of them started to ask me to create pieces outside of the show. And that's kind of how it all got started. One of my favorite parts of doing all of this artwork was actually hair. So for all of my hula sisters, my favorite part was taking apart all these bouquets that we received from some of our friends in Japan. And I would make their hair, you know, put their hair together. And that really was my passion. But Auntie Vicky actually saw that and was like, you know, you're very expressive. You know, I have this project that she was doing, the MAMo Arts, and she said, you know, you belong doing this. You know, that this is, I can see that this is your passion. Why don't you try it? And I was like, what do I do? You know, what is it? Like, I don't have a line or anything. And she's like, that's the best part about wearable arts. Reconnecting that time and space between our past and our present and moving on into the future. And not only that, looking at the fluidity of our culture today, the reform and the shapes and the silhouettes that you see in an art piece can really are very informative of what was happening to the artist at the time. It's about creating that connectivity and flowing through and being expressive and as creative as we can be for the future to move on and to really feel pono with and feel that connectivity.
Okay, so I'm gonna say, I remember when I saw Manaola at your show, Robert Uluvehi Casimero, in Japan. And I was watching in the dressing room how he was dressing his mother and his auntie and his sister and his dancers. And I was looking at that young boy and I was like, oh my gosh, you know, it was just amazing. So I told him, I said, you need to be in my fashion show. I just need 10 looks. And he said, oh, auntie, I'm not a designer. I said, oh yeah, you are. Oh yes, I know it. I can see it. So give me 10 looks. And the show is, you know, you have a few months to work on it. And look at what came out of that young man, yes. I tell you.
Amazing.
Cultural practitioner, dancer, but because he's printing and making the kapa and all those designs, he has all of that design elements. And to put it together and the way it came out tonight, I was like, amazing. I didn't expect that. Trust me, that was...
He's always been talented. I mean, even as a young kid up in Waimea, you know, watching him grow up, just fabulous what he's done, you know, with it today. Just wonderful work.
Blows my mind, the talent that is in that one individual, Carrington Baba.
Yes.
It's just, it's beautiful to see what he puts out there for us to enjoy.
And took it all the way to the New York fashion show in New York City.
Yep.
But he remembers his roots.
He does.
He does remember his roots, you know.
His mama.
Give him lots of credit.
His dad,
yeah.
Awesome.
Great work. Thanks, Baba.
Yay! Thank you so much, everybody. Ayayaya kawayakani. Ayayilala, ikahonua, ikawaihu, ikawaikawakani mekanalo. Kevaipuna, kevaili, kevaemana, kevaiola, yolanoe. When you're in the presence of the artist and you're in the middle of a room full of Native Hawaiians that are like celebrating our art and celebrating our culture, I mean, it's just that energy, and it is uplifting to all of us that work on the show, but also I'm pretty sure rewarding for the artists that are being presented.
You know, I'm always lucky because I get to see the things from two different sides of the stage. One from the side of the back, one to the monitor, and one from the front as I'm helping you direct in the back. And I get to see everything unfold. You know, it's fabulous watching the rush in the back, the designers putting the clothes on, to the last hairpin, to the last brooch, to the last earring that goes on to these people, to make that piece just work.
Yeah, and then there's me and Ulvehi just enjoying the show from the front end.
Yeah, and then there's just me trying
when you to make remember sure to I can bring read script correctly. With you.
Yes, with the script, and thank God Vicky's right there to help me. But I was going to say, I'm on the opposite side, because usually at the very beginnings, I'd be working, and I would just slip in there to help with the show in any way that I could. And to see that thing come, the MAMo Wearable Art Show, to come to fruition, I mean, you know, we don't have lots and lots of money to work with. We do what we can, and we try and make it honorable and beautiful and respectful. And these designers, with their talent and their style, all of them, help to make it a memorable and unforgettable experience every year.
Every year.
Every year.
So we hope that we can come back sometime soon and do this live. Hey, aloha, hey, aloha. We want to see this face to face. Because you need that energy, and they feed off of that energy as well. And we want to be able to see each and every one of you next time we do the MAMo Wearable Art Show.
Yes, we do.
So cheers to the staff.
Cheers.
Cheers to everybody.
And cheers
Mahalo,
to you.
And cheers to you. And we'll see you. We'll see you soon. Aloha.
Aloha.
Vicky and I find ourselves waving our phones like they're flames.
Because, you know, we're high tech now.
Oh, my God. Go, Vicky, help me.
I gave him the script, you know.
I'm going to say that again.
Paradicus. Or Paradisus.
Hi.
Well, hi. How are you?
Nice meeting you here.
Yeah, nice to see you again this year.
Yes.
You're looking great, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah. Roses.
Roses, yeah.
Flowers. Roses. Pretty face. Nice haircut.
E hula ka ko. Let's hula together. Vicky and Jeff Takamine, Nā Kumu Hula of Pua Ali'i I Lima, are excited to announce open enrollment for new students from Keiki to Kupuna. You can register for a 12-week introductory class to our Halau Hula, Pua Ali'i I Lima, at www.paifoundation.org. We look forward to meeting you. E komo mai.